Democrats are promising a bigger government, but public pension payments are squeezing local governments across the country. A lot of the nation's programs are underfunded. Adam Shapiro has the details from our newsroom. Adam.
Deirdre, we've talked about the pension crisis before, and it has not gone away. All of the unfunded liabilities for state and local and city municipal pensions is now over $4 trillion. What's troubling is this latest report, which comes from Wilshire Trust Universe Comparison Service. This is just a preliminary report, a projected figure. But at the end of the second quarter, public pensions, the return on investments is going to fall for the first time since they started looking at this. The 20-year average is going to fall below 7.5%. It's going to come in, according to Wilshire, most likely at 7.47%. Now, why is this important? The lower that figure, the return on investment, you don't have to be a genius to know this, the more that figure drops, the more money that has to come out of your pocket as a taxpayer to keep pensions healthy and to pay the already retired public employees. And here are the states that face the greatest hurdles when it comes to unfunded pension liabilities. Illinois leads the list, 39% of its pensions funded. Kentucky, 44% funded. Connecticut, 48% funded. Alaska, 52% funded. New Hampshire, 57% funded. Now, states that are in a good position with their pensions, South Dakota, 99% funded, as is Wisconsin. Tennessee, 94% funded. New York, 89% funded. And Washington, 88% funded. At the end of the day, when pensions, public pensions, fail to return an investment, a rate of return greater than 7.5%, it means you, the taxpayers, have to foot the bill. And that number, that return is dropping, your bill is going up. Deirdre.
Adam Shapiro, thank you so much.